Hey, what's up YouTube? This is We All Juggle Knives and Lights with a video and a discussion on flashlights, particularly throwers, as well as a demonstration of this Thru-Night TN42, one of my favorite throwers. Now, I've already reviewed this, so this is not the review, right? But this is a great light, 2000 lumens, and the maximum beam distance is 1550 meters. That is way farther than anyone can see, but as we will discuss, you know, a thrower is not always meant for to actually use 1,000 meters away. All right, there you see the battery compartment, the four 18650 cells. You know, first you have to understand max beam distance. What does that figure mean? What does that term mean? Basically, that's the distance at which a light will provide you with amount of illumination roughly equivalent to what you would get if the moon was out at night. So at max beam distance, you are going to be getting less than one lumen per square meter. All right, so that's just a standardized term. Here is some usage footage. So I was just checking out the backyard the other night, and I saw a little pair of eyes off in the distance. You see how far away this thing is. That's not even a full-grown possum. It's like, I think it's a baby possum. That's how far away I am. I was in the second story window, and that is this light, the TN42, right? So that is, what is the distance there? Well, it's across my yard and then across the neighbor's backyard as well. Here's what you gotta understand about max beam distance. If the max beam distance of a light is some insane figure, like 1.5 kilometers, that doesn't mean you're going to see a man-sized target lit up like daylight at 1.5 kilometers. Not at all. In fact, because max beam distance is less than one lumen per square meter, when demonstrated on a camcorder, you're not going to see anything because a camcorder can't even focus, you know, with less than a lumen per square meter that far away. Yeah, you're not going to see anything, right? So the purpose of max beam distance, it's to give you a standardized figure from which you can then estimate what would be the usable distance. See, this is a more practical distance that I'm demonstrating, you know, about 2.5 backyards away. If a threat is farther than that, then they're not really much of a threat yet, are they? You know, unless it's a sniper, then you're dead. But if a light has a crazy high max beam distance, imagine how good that light will do at lesser distances. So if I get a 1,000 meter light, I don't get that light because it's going to light something up at 1,000 meters. I get it because if that's the max beam distance, imagine how good that light will be at 100 meters. And this is a perfect demonstration of a situation like that. Yeah, so sometimes people will stay away from the extreme throwers because they think, oh, well, I don't need to see anything at 1,000 meters. I can't even see that far. Of course, but that's not really what the point of 1,000 meter max beam distance light is. The point is that at more practical distances, like let's say a football field or two, that light is going to dominate. This thing can pick out this tiny little possum. It's almost at the limit of what you could even see with your naked eye. I could only see this without the zoom because it has little glowing eyes like many animals do. So what I would say is that even if your flashlight needs are mainly like just to check out your backyard and maybe any trespassers in the neighbor's yard as well, that doesn't mean that you can't use a thrower. Throwers work excellent, especially for lighting up a man-sized target at those distances. So don't be afraid to get an extreme thrower. They can be used at practical distances very well. And they might have less of a flood, but all you have to do is basically just traverse the flashlight back and forth quickly, and you'll be able to see the whole scene. Yeah, that's a beautiful shot right there. That right there explains visually why I like long throw flashlights. Yeah, so this flashlight is particularly capable. It is an expensive flashlight, no doubt, but it performs. I will include links to this light and other through-night lights. Right, but... And now I tried to get good shots of the possum, but it kept, like, showing me its possum ass. Yeah, this is where your wife walks in and catches you watching YouTube, and she's like, are you watching some guy shine a flashlight on a possum's butt? And you're like, no, this is important. This is important internet research on preparedness. And she's like, I don't know, I think you have enough flashlights. And you're like, I want a divorce. Now, hopefully not. Hopefully no divorce, but... This is important internet research. All right, this is a deer. This was the next night, same general area. Look, check out the antlers. Yeah, but yeah, that's why I love long throw flashlights. And I hope this has been educational as well as just entertaining. Wanted to explain better what the max beam distance actually means. So in conclusion, basically, you want something with a very high max beam distance figure. Not because you can see 1,000 meters away with your naked eye, but because at 100 meters, that thrower is just going to kick so much ass and dominate. Look how far that is. I mean, it's not hundreds of meters, but you can see even just a few backyards away, you know, the naked eyes can't zoom that much. We're not eagles. All right, I hope you enjoyed this video. I will include links to this flashlight, some through nights, as well as some budget alternatives. Please check out the links. They do help support the channel. This has been We All Juggle Knives and Lights. I'm out.